Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
First of all, I would like to extend my appreciation to the organizing committee of the UNESCO. I would like to thank Professor Dr. Fung Song Fook and also Associate Professor Dr. Kenneth Rodriguez, and not needless to say that to Mr. Joe Hironaka. So the reason is why this is the first actually conference where I am going to talk about something on visual impairment, because most of my conference paper and talk is about history. Perhaps history is the very boring subject. So today's subject is not a boring one. Okay. Alright. I would like to focus more on the issue of open educational resources as to recognize its importance to the blind community. So my topic is more focused than what had been briefly mentioned or discussed by Professor Dr. Rosita before. So I try to use my experience, but hopefully it's not going to be very sentimental value. I try to impersonalize this, because my experience is a common experience to all the blind, actually, not only myself. But luckily, I achieved to this academic accomplishment up to the PhD level. Okay. First of all, when we talk about education for the blind or visual impaired, it must be inclusive. It must be, because we are living in the world in which world is created for all, not for the blind only. So the blind must adapt themselves to the mainstream society. And the only element available for the blind since their childhood up to adolescence and so on is education. Education exposure. So the education must be very inclusive, not exclusive for the blind. Because when I write, let's say I produce an article or I teach, the quality must be equal to the normal writers, the cited writers in academic world. This is what I was have to face during my study from especially at tertiary level up to my PhD level. Okay. So I have prepared some slide, but I don't know whether I am going to follow the slide exactly or not. But let me begin with this inclusive education for the blind first. Okay, basically, education is something very common. It's not for the mainstream society, but it also must include the blind. But the problem now is blind have limited access to acquire the information and so on. Information and also knowledge, which is needed in the process of education. Okay. The fundamental way for the blind to acquire all this are literacy. So for the blind, the literacy is Braille. Why is Braille? Because Louis Braille, who invented this system in early 19th century in French. In France. So, okay, if you look at me now, imagine I cannot read Braille, so I'm illiterate. Because I cannot play, I'm not able to prepare my slide just now in Braille version, So I have to speak on what I can memorize at this moment. Okay, Braille is only for the blind, exclusive for the blind, but not for the mainstream society. But fortunately, in my case, I was brought up in Malaysia during my primary and secondary school. Malaysian government or Malaysian Ministry of Education was very concerned about this blind education. So all the textbooks actually were put in Braille. In Braille. Either they put it, in those days it was mainly initiated or done by Malaysian Association for the Blind. Of course, they receive some fund from Ministry of Education, also public donation and so on. Otherwise, the only source of info we have is by we acquire from the assistance from these voluntary readers. So this was what I experienced during my secondary school in particular, and also in particular because in my school, Moa High School, they have the society called Friends of the Blind. Since I was in Form 1 up to Upper 6, we were associated this society, Friends of the Blind. Oh, they are very helpful, free of charge. So what we did is, they teach us science, mathematics, the seniors mostly, the seniors. And then they read and then we braille it, all the notes, okay, in addition to this textbook. So I use this kind of environment or a way of acquiring this reading material from my secondary school up to Form 6, up to my STPM, Sijil Tinggi Pelajaran Malaysia OJ, which is high school certificate. But unfortunately, when I entered, I was admitted to tertiary level, this system is no longer formalized. So now I have to depend on informal institution, which is voluntary readers. And throughout my study, actually, from in UM 1990 to 1992, I have many readers. One of the most loyal, my most loyal is my wife. Because what they did is, Braille material is no longer practical. Okay, Braille actually is very important. It's a fundamental literacy to the blind. Braille is like to you all. No matter you have computer, you have tablet, all this, it's still like a pen and paper, pencil and paper. So this is Braille. We need this kind of very basic one. What is my pen and paper? It's Braille. Of course, I heard that there was development in US already. Many blind actually now don't learn Braille anymore. I don't know how they can survive. It's very simple. When note taking, for instance, for the blind, how can they take note without Braille? Okay, they can use the iPhone also on the Android, but they still need this. This Braille literacy as well, like the pen and paper. So the most conventional Braille device we have is the Perkins Braille. The Perkins Braille is like the normal typewriter, but the Braille system. So I think the picture is there. So I still use this until now. Until now, this is my pen and papers. Okay. So the other way, when we share to readers is on in university, of course, I cannot expect them to stay with me to read and then I type. So mostly we use cassette recording in those days. In fact, most of my lectures, even up to master's level, I use cassette recording, recorder actually. In fact, when I studied in London, I bought my own recorder from Malaysia because in Malaysia it's cheaper. In London, it's very expensive. Everything is expensive. Even more, if you convert to pound sterling, in those days, 4 ringgit per pound is still expensive already. Now, okay. So for lectures. But, okay, it was quite fortunate for the blind actually. In the 1990s, we have computer development. Okay, it's a normal computer, but the problem in those days, the sound blaster in the computer is not sophisticated enough yet. So they have to invent the screen reader, which is the additional device to computer in those days. But nowadays, this system actually, especially the pirate copy one, is like a sound card only, or software. You just download, install, and then with some kind of configuration, now it's a cracked file, then we use that. So the most common software we use as a blind is JAWS, J-A-W-S, JAWS. I think Dr. Resista mentioned just now NVDA. NVDA is good, but for me it's not friendly enough. So I use JAWS, I still use JAWS, the cracked version one. Because the original one is very expensive. It's about 3,000 ringgit. And now, this JAWS, actually, we have to use to upgrade every year. So it's very expensive. Okay. Talking about money, Braille books is also very expensive. Okay, one, let's say, a book of 300 pages, it can cost about 10 volume books, 10 volume. But I am quite a little bit clever. I just compile in a big file and then it make the volumes became less. So maybe 3 or 4. During my school days, I still remember one of my mathematics books, from one book is 24 volume. During my form 4, I still remember my physical geography book is about 18 volume. So can you imagine all these books now at tertiary level is very thick. You are talking about Cambridge history of Southeast Asia. I don't know how many volumes it is. So that's why we need. During these 1990s, with the development in computer, when I started my master's and PhD, we have little development, which they call it scanning version. The computer got voice, so they devised the special reading program in which we have to scan the book page by page until it finish. So it will be converted into soft copy version, and then we can listen to it. So the most friendly software I use is called OpenBook. They got dictionary inside there, they can navigate and so on. It's very good. But I used to use Reading Advantage, which I had to buy it about £799 actually. But we can install only 3 tries. Then that's it. So also, this is the technology I used during my master's and PhD, So I was productive in scanning all these books. Especially during my time in UIA, IIUM. My most productive years was in 2011. I don't know how many books I borrowed from the library, but in that year, I got the prize of the best reader. Not because I read the book, but I scan the book. I see. Okay. There is. But books and reading this scanning book have also its own problem. It's own problem. Okay, if the book is vandalized,
As they say, these professors usually they like to underline, they like to put the mark there, the word they like. All this is disturb my scanning. it disturbed me. So what happened is I have to ask my wife. Okay, luckily if they use pencil is okay. But if you pen, then I have no way. But mostly they use pencil. It's lucky lah. So I asked my wife to erase it. Then I scan it. But some of the book is not very friendly scanning as well, right? Because the font is too small and so on lah. This one, okay. Then I moved to Sabah. Okay, the technology became more and more accessible to the blind now with the coming of PDF version. Okay, PDF version. PDF version have two types actually. Maybe for the sighted there are no different, but for us they are different. I think this one also had been mentioned by Dr. Rosita just now. One is the text form actually, the character one, the real character one, alphabet. The second one is actual picture. Okay, the character one is okay, we can read. But the picture one, when you on enter, when you open the file, it's a blank page. It's a blank page actually. Many scan. See, nowadays, they send letters to staff, they scan it and then they post it. Which is, for me, is useless at all. It's a blank page. But with this development, PDF, this is the so-called open educational resource. The source for this OER, actually, I use is Bookfinder. So if you Google use your phone to Google or your computer Google, you just type bookfi, B-O-O-K-F-I. You will find the link there, you go there, and then you type the subject. Frankly speaking, I have done it, actually, I have downloaded more than 3,000 books already. 3,000. Okay. The reason why I did this because when I migrated to UMS, UMS was kind enough to buy me another machine called Braille Apex. Okay, the Braille Apex, it used, the main reason I want this is because I can read PDF form, they convert it to text, and what I did is, I just copy and paste into Microsoft form. Of course, in terms of footnote, it become like PDF lah, but is in Microsoft Word. Because the most friendly software to the blind is Microsoft Word. That one is undeniable. And then you have Excel and so on, that is a different matter lah, but still MS Word is the most friendly. Even RTF or TXT, that one is not friendly enough because we cannot sense the paging. So if we have to do the footnoting and so on, this citation is very difficult. By using Microsoft Word, it's quite easy. We can navigate page to page, paragraph to and so on. Although maybe the attribute is no longer the same, but at least this is good enough for the blind. So this Bookfinder is my source of OER at this moment. Otherwise, JSTOR, as long as it's in PDF, then I can use the same technique by Braille Apex to convert into text and then copy and paste it into Microsoft Word. For me, that is good enough. That is good enough. And this is the reason why when I was assigned to teach, let's say, European history, for instance, I was happy. Because European history, you can get the books very easy. There's very many, many texts. Even, I think in this sense, teaching human history is much easier than teaching Malaysian history. Okay. This benefit actually, not benefit me, but I actually give the copy to my sighted friend. Because they also took over my course actually, European history eventually. So I give them. Even some have student, PhD student, I actually download from them and I give it to them. This happened actually. So you see, this is beneficial, not only for me, but also for the sighted, which I never thought before. In those days, I always ask the material reading from the sighted, but now I can give the material reading to the sighted now. And this is all fact, not the myth actually. I'm not lying anyway. Just to show you the fun. Okay. But unfortunately, all these things came after my PhD. So I could imagine if this kind of technology came to me during my PhD, it could be a different different way already. But it's okay. Time, history. Okay. What happened now is OER, this so-called OER is very good. My book finder is very good. But in doing research, I still have problem because in history, I have to access to archival material. So okay lah, I'm lecturer now, I can employ my RA to collect data and so. So I can use the research fund to pay them for this key in the something. But I wish that there was a technology that which can read handwritten. But handwritten actually in reading software is like a picture actually. All the reading material to the scanner is a picture actually. So they require extra additional software to convert to text, like OpenBook, Reading Advantage and so on, or HAL and so on, which is by Dolphin, Dolphin product. So this one is easily can be Google one. So in history, this is the problem. But nowadays, with the advancement of technology, this OER is so good. Because let's say during like one of the place I work with for my PhD to gather data was, in those days they call it Public Record Office. But now it's National Archive at Kew, UK. So they have some data already in internet and so on, which it can be downloaded by a sighted person. But for the blind, these materials are still useless because in picture form. But that is good enough because, in Book Finder, I also find many books actually, a few books, interesting book, but it's a picture form. So as a blind, I know some kind, if the size of the file is very big, then I know that is a picture already. Because normally, if you see that the book by Routledge, normally is about 2 megabyte and some only, 2 megabyte. But if you find the book 20 megabyte, then I know that's a picture already. But some of the book actually, I like it. I like it. Although in a picture form, so what I did is, I photocopy it, I print it, using EMS facility, and then I scan it. Scan it. But with, frankly speaking, with the emergence of Book Finder, I am also become lazy to scan already. That is my problem. So technology make me also lazy. So my record in UIA, I was the best reader, have gone away. So in this sense, I wish the technology became more and more advanced in future. Maybe now it's even become possible. But as a blind community today, I would like to express my thanks to all who have made the blind to live easier, and also who intend to make the blind to live easier with this education. All effort to improve the blind, especially in reading and so on, is very welcome, and we really appreciate it because we also don't know how to improve all this, to improvise this product. Because what I learned, Jenny, most of the software developed in US, for instance, is developed by the adult blind. Yeah, some of the blind, they are engineers. They became blind. They are the IT experts, so they know how to devise this. So sometimes maybe like, I wish not the adult blind, but they actually know. Because all this computer knowledge, IT, is associated with this reading, soft screen reader and so on. So that is why we need somebody who are expert in this field to devise a more advanced product to open this to questioning. Okay, nowadays, even annual report, for instance, annual report or all government gazette, which is published online, we can download and then can read it. For instance, Royal Inquiry, Royal Commission Inquiry, for instance. So I have downloaded a few of them, really. Including the VK Linger one, the RCI on this illegal immigrant in Sabah. It's readable now through this way. I still use the same technique by download it, PDF form, and then I convert into text by using my Braille Apex. And from there, I copy and paste into Microsoft form. So this is the only way we can have access. Last but not least, I would like to thank this organization to give me opportunity to share with you all my experience and the challenges I face. Thank you very much.